lies Ireland. And in front of us, a journey to the past, to the time of the Second World War. Eyewitnesses from Dublin want to report to us about the so-called work training camp in Farge, a camp which had been run by the Gestapo near Bremen. We meet in the evening with our second interviewee, Harry Callan, born 1923. He had worked as a civilian on the SS African Star, a British merchant vessel. The war marines sank the freighter and put the crew under arrest. That's how Callan came to work on the bunker construction site in Bremen-Farge. U-boats were to be assembled here, protected against any bomb attacks by walls and ceilings which were meters thick. Callan had to help pour the foundation and fortify the dike, all work that had been completed by the time the photos had been taken in 1944 by the construction foreman and head of the Marine Planning and Building Department, Steig. Callan and his fellow inmates were housed in the so-called work training camp. These photos are from the 60s.
Just cattle, working cattle, that's all. You're fed, you're watered, and you've got a place to bed down for the few hours. And you're herded like cattle. And you're put into a bunch like cattle, groups of five in this case. But I don't know how it came about, but we always seemed to keep ourselves at the end of the line. The areas that were out working, that were able to work, we always kept together and kept our own little circle or little square behind the main square set, or in front of it. But there was nobody else mixed with us. We kept to ourselves.
After the war, Callan had first not talked at all about what had happened, not even to his wife. Prompted by Peter Mulvany, Callan travels for the first time to Farge after 60 years.